In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a custom font to your Squarespace website. Now, at the time of recording, there is not an easy built-in way to do this in Squarespace, unfortunately. Hopefully, they add this feature in the future, but for now, we can add a custom font using some CSS code, and that is what I'm going to show you in this video. But before I get to that, I just wanted to briefly mention that there are tons of fonts already built into Squarespace that you can use. So if you go over here to Site Styles by clicking on this paintbrush icon, and then click on this arrow button next to fonts. And then if you go into headings or paragraphs, depending on the font that you want to change, so headings will be for, you know, these heading text blocks, and then paragraphs will be for the smaller text blocks. So if you go into one of those and then click on the font up here, this is where you can scroll through and see all the fonts that are available within Squarespace already, just like built in. And you can see how tiny this little scroll bar handle is. Like this, there are tons of fonts in here. If you're wanting to use a font from like Google Fonts or Adobe Fonts, there's a good chance that it already exists here in this list of fonts that is built into Squarespace. So you can just start typing the font up here and see if it exists. And sometimes you might need to click on additional fonts. So if I look for this one, Ivy, it's not showing up. But if I click on additional fonts, then I can see all these Ivy fonts here. Not all of the Google and Adobe fonts are available in this list, but it doesn't hurt to check if your font is already available within Squarespace, because that makes it so much easier. Let's say your font is not in this list. Let's say it's a font that you purchased on a marketplace like Creative Market or some other font foundry website. Or it could be a Google font that is just not available here. Google Fonts are free, by the way, so this is a good website to check out for fonts if you're still looking for fonts. So if the font that you want is not here in this list of available fonts, then we're gonna have to add it with some custom CSS. One more quick note. If the font you want to add is an Adobe font, which if you have an Adobe plan that lets you access Adobe fonts, then you can add any of these Adobe fonts to your website. So that only applies to people that have an Adobe plan. If that is the case for you and you're not finding the font that you want to add in this list, there is a separate process for adding Adobe fonts. And I will cover that in a separate video. So I'll link to that video here once it is available. Okay, so we're gonna exit out of here and we're gonna go into the custom CSS menu. So if you type the slash key on your keyboard, it will bring up this search bar, which you can also access by clicking on this search button right here. And if you start typing in CSS, it will bring up the custom CSS page. So you can go ahead and click on that. Also, just to show you another way you can get to this page, at the time of recording, to get to the custom CSS page, you go into pages, scroll all the way down to custom code, and then click on custom CSS. So from here, go into custom files. This is where you're going to upload the font file. So if you have a custom font that you downloaded from Google or from some other website, you should have a .ttf or .otf or .woff file that you can upload right here. So I'm going to do that now with a font file that I have. So now that we have the font file uploaded to our website, we have to define this font file in our custom CSS code. So I'm going to paste in some code right here. I'm going to put this code block in the description below this video so you can grab it from there, but you are going to have to modify it. So if you paste that into your custom CSS and then position your cursor in between these quotations right next to URL, next to SRC URL, and then in between these quotations, make sure your cursor is right there. And then you're going to go into this drop down and then you're going to click on that file, that font file that you uploaded. Okay. And once you click on it, Squarespace is going to paste the entire link to that font file that is hosted on your website, wherever your cursor was. Okay. So if you messed up, you can just undo it and try again. Then we're going to change the format. So the format is going to be TrueType. If your file extension for your font file is .ttf or .otf. If it's either of those, then you're going to leave format as TrueType. If the file ends instead in WOFF, then you're going to change format to WOFF. And if it ends in WOF2, then you're going to change it to WOF2. So the format will just be dependent on the file type that you have for your font file. So we have the SRC, the source, and we have the format. Now we're going to define the font family. And this can really be whatever you want to call this font. You can just use whatever it's called. So I'm going to call it 90s. I'm just going to put that here. You can even just call it like heading font if you want. So now we have installed our font into our custom CSS, but we need to tell Squarespace where we want it to use this font. And we have different types of text that we can apply this font to. If we go into edit, I just want to show you the different types of text that we have available. If I click on this and then I click on the pencil icon, you'll see this is set to heading one. So we have 4 different heading types and we have 3 different paragraph types. We're going to ignore monospace because that's mostly used for displaying code on your website. So you're probably not going to want to use that. So each of these text types has a corresponding selector or like a little code that identifies it. And that is what we're going to use in the custom CSS to tell Squarespace which text types that we want to apply our font to. So for heading one, we have H1, lowercase h. For heading two, we have H2. For paragraph one, we have .sqsrte-large, etc., etc. Note that paragraph one and three have a dot before them, but the rest of them do not. So if we wanted to apply our new font to all 4 of our heading types, this is what we would do. I'm going to go on to a new line outside of this bracket. You see how this bracket closes this bracket. So we want to make sure that we always have closing brackets for our open brackets. Okay, so down here, I'm going to type in H1, comma, H2, comma, H3, comma, H4. And you can have spaces in between them if you want, but you don't have to. And then I'm going to type an open bracket and then I'm going to hit enter. So we have the closing bracket here too. And then inside here, I'm going to type in font family colon. And then I'm going to use this name right here that I assigned to the font family up here. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to put it right here. And then I'm going to put a semicolon. And you can see it's already taken effect. So the heading 1, 2, 3, and 4 are now using this 90s font. So now that I've done that, I can actually see with this specific font, the letters are really close together. So I'm going to save that. And then I'm going to go into site styles, fonts, headings, and right here I can add a little bit of letter spacing and also change the font weight down a little bit, maybe to 500. And actually now that I've changed the weight, I like it better at 0 for the letter spacing. So after you add the font, even though this right here isn't the font anymore, you can still change these other font styles and it'll apply with your new font. That's how we apply it to the heading font. So let's say you want to add another font for the paragraph fonts. I'm going to just copy this and paste it here. And then I'm going to upload another font. Once it's finished uploading, then I'm going to click out of it and I'm going to delete this URL, go back into custom files, click on this and make sure that it got inserted right in between the 2 quotes. And then I need to change the font family and I'm going to change it to blue. Okay, so now we have 2 fonts, 2 custom fonts in our custom CSS, right? We have this 90s, which we are currently applying to H1, 2, 3, and 4, heading 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we have this other font, blue, and I'm going to apply this blue to the paragraph text. So sqsrte-large, comma, p, comma, dot sqsrte-small, do the open brackets, enter, and then I'm going to say font family, colon, and then I'm just going to copy this with the quotes and paste it down here. And you can see that the paragraph fonts now just changed to this new font, blue. If you wanted all 3 paragraph types to use the same font, you actually don't need to include all 3 of them because SQ sqsrte-large and small are technically also P elements. So we could just replace all of this with a single lowercase p, and that would apply this font to all paragraphs on the website. See, like this text right here is paragraph one, and it is using the same font as paragraph two. But just for demonstration purposes, I wanted to show you all three. If you wanted one of these paragraph types to be a different font, for example, if we wanted this paragraph one text to be this other font, we could bring it over here like this, and then it would take this other font. So I just wanted to show you how you could distinguish between all three of the paragraph types. So I'm going to save that. These fonts up here did not change, and that's because these are not headings or paragraph elements. These are links. If you want to apply a font to all links on your website, you can do comma A. You can add important so that this font takes precedent over other fonts that Squarespace might want to use for these text elements. So A applies to all links. So that includes the site title because this is a link. It includes the button text because these are links, and it includes these links up here in the navigation. But it also includes, if you go into blog, and on this page, these are links. These link to the blog page itself. See, if we take out the A right here and save it and refresh, now these are using the header font because these are header elements that also have a link within them. Let's see, if we inspect it, we can see that this is a H1 element, but within the H1 element, we have an A element, which is a link. So if you want all of the links that are within heading elements to also use the same heading font, which you probably do, then we have to add some additional code here. We'll have to add a comma, and then we'll add H1 space A, so that targets all links. A stands for link. All links within H1 elements will also use this font family. And we have to do that for each of the heading types. I'm just gonna copy and paste the rest of these, add a comma, and then paste them here. And then I'm just gonna go through and add space A to each of them. That will make sure that all of the heading elements that have links within them will also use the heading font. I'm going to add the A back here. I'm not sure how that got deleted, but there are a ton of places throughout your website that these will not apply to. For example, this right here, this text, the date, is not using either of our custom fonts. And we can investigate that. If you're using Chrome, Google Chrome, you can right click and go down to inspect. And then if we use this little button right here, we can hover over the element. You can see that it is still using pop-ins. It's not using either of our new fonts. We can click on the element. And then if we go over here, we can see that that element is actually a time element. It's within this caret right here. It says time and then space. So this first part right here is the type of element that it is. Usually this would just be P. So like, for example, if I click on this, you see this is just a paragraph element. So that's why it picks up this font right here, because we have P assigned to blue, right? And this is using the blue font. We did not include the time element in any of this. So if we want this to also be blue, then we can add a comma and add time, and then it should pick up that font. So there may be some places throughout your website where you'll notice that it's not picking up the font. So you'll just have to do a little bit of investigating to figure out what element that is and include it in your custom CSS code. Like I said, this isn't very straightforward, and hopefully Squarespace makes it easier in the future to use custom fonts. But for now, this is what we have to do to get it to work. Hopefully that was helpful. If it was, I would really appreciate it if you could hit that like button underneath this video. If you need more help building out your Squarespace website, why don't you check out my website, jen-webb.com. I'll also put that link in the description below. You can hire me to help you with technical issues you're having on your Squarespace website, or to just build out the whole website for you. So check that out. That's all for now. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.